What's up, guys? Just started the truck up, let it warm up, but I put the Skag on a battery charger last night, and I put a heater blowing directly on the oil pan. So it's nice and warm. It's blowing straight up in there. Should have the engine fairly warm. It brought it up probably about 20 degrees in here. I'm still guessing it's probably mid 30s. And this mower, I've had issues with it at 30 before. So we're gonna give her a go and see if we can get it to start. But we did have the battery charger on it over there. You can see it sitting all night long. So let's give it a go, see if we can get it to start. I'm gonna go ahead and take the battery charger off here real quick. Fingers crossed, fellas. Step out here real quick. I tried to idle it down. I'm pulling the idle down to try to bring the RPMs down. Don't want to idle down. It's stuck all the way up. Give her a go again, see if we can get it to come down. Alright, it must have warmed up enough to get that to be able to move. But what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to leave this run here for a while. I want to get that engine nice and warm, get that oil nice and hot. I got to go get blood work done, so I'll tell Savannah to walk out here in like 20 minutes and shut it off, okay? Just walk in real quick, shut it off, walk right back out, okay? Love you. All right, mower's warming up. I got to go get blood work done. I got to do blood work like every month before my monthly doctor's appointments, just to make sure like my vitamin levels and all that, sugar levels and vitamin D and all that crap is, you know, good to go. So I'm glad I actually got the mower started. I got to get that one taken out to the dealer at some point this week. We're on it's Tuesday. They actually canceled schools here today. Not for my kids. My kids, they're in a different district, but the city schools, they canceled. And tomorrow it's supposed to be even colder, so I'm anticipating our kids go back tomorrow. I'm anticipating they actually cancel tomorrow, probably Thursday, possibly even Friday. The high here, I think Thursday or Friday, is like 8 degrees. So once that wind chill gets in the negative 15 to 20 area, they normally cancel school because a lot of these kids still walk to school. Go ahead.
Thank you. Don't want you to stand in
that cold. All right, guys. Got my blood work done. It was pretty easy actually this time. Tell you what, I wasn't looking forward to getting poked after the surgery. I got poked so many freaking times. My arms and legs and stomach, everything. The last thing I wanted to do was give blood, I'll tell you right now, but it honestly wasn't bad at all. So let's go see what else we can get into today. All right, fellas, went ahead and got the other light hung. This little Eden Pure heater I borrowed off my dad. He had it just sitting in his garage. It doesn't make it warm in here, but it makes it so that you're not freezing to death. Now, don't get me wrong. If you guys can see the holes going through the roof, that goes into my foyer where the addition was added on. Eventually, I do want to put insulation through all of this and maybe even drywall the ceiling at some point. But, you know, this garage is not, it's not built to keep heat in, if you know what I'm saying. This is an old school type garage. I mean, this house was built in 57. So, I mean, it's, what, 70 years old, I think. So, you know, back in the day, they didn't care. They just wanted a garage. But that Eden Pier is helping out some. I can work with no gloves on. My hands aren't freezing to death. I mean, don't get me wrong, guys. It's still cold out here. But I went ahead and raised them up, too. I took them up, I think, about 8 inches on each one. And the same with this one over here. And then all I did with the cord, I was going to tack it because I got these little white tacks that I can actually like nail on each side of the wire without affecting the wire. But I was like, you know what? Screw it. I'm just going to wrap it around the freaking truss here and then just plug it in. So if at some point I may end up adding two more here, maybe one down at the end there, and then maybe one more over here. I haven't really decided yet because I'm moving this bench this spring, summertime. I'm actually going to move my workbench to this wall over here so I have more depth in the garage to put the mower further back and the car or whatever. So I may end up moving this light, but what I'm thinking is if I add just one more here, it'll pretty much be right above where my workbench is going to be anyways. So I may just leave those two and just add one more possibly here, or maybe even a lower light, I don't know. But yeah, garage is coming along, guys. I honestly, I can't do a whole lot still. I'm still on 15-pound regulation. As you guys seen the other day, I did pack around the backpack blowers, and they're roughly 22 to 24, roughly, pounds. But, you know, I'm not straining myself. That's the biggest thing. They don't want me to strain so that I have a hernia or anything like that. I'm a pretty strong person, you know, generally. I can lift heavy things, so I mean, I don't think I'm hurting myself in any way lifting the backpack blower or anything like that, or a ladder or whatever. But I have to keep myself busy, guys. I know it seems like I'm making a lot of videos in the garage here, but honestly, this is my way of keeping my mind off of the surgery or food or anything like that. I don't have any cravings. I really don't even get hungry, honestly. Like, I have to tell myself, hey, go eat. Or, you know, your mind's like, hey, it's breakfast time, eat breakfast. Hey, it's lunch time, eat some lunch. Hey, it's dinner time, go eat something. But I have no desire or hunger to want to go eat. So I'm trying to keep myself as busy as possible out here in the garage, even though it's, man, we've had some cold temperatures. As you guys all know, this has been a deep freeze like we have not had in a long time. A matter of fact, I have a screenshot of last year. I'll plug it in here. I'll put it right here. During this week last year, we were like 35, 55, and I believe we even had a 60 in there. Don't hold me to it, but I remember having that screenshot from right around the beginning of the year last year that we had a 60. We were super mild last year, guys. We were like southern type temperatures, 60s, 50s. You know, we got down a few times, but man, the high on Thursday, guys, is 5 degrees here. Five. They canceled school here this morning because the wind chill was negative 17. Anytime it gets negative 15 or higher, they have to cancel school here because of the kids that walk to school. So I'm trying to keep myself busy, fellas. YouTube is helping out with that a lot. This is giving me opportunities to make videos for you guys and kind of help you out along the way. And that's what I love doing. That's what I've always loved doing, is helping, you know, the up-and-coming guys, and even some of the guys that have been doing this a long time that, you know, maybe they've went a bit stagnant or lost a little bit of desire, or, you know, are just looking for new ways to market or, you know, get new clients or anything, you know. Sometimes when you're in a business forever, like I was watching, what do they call it? Hell's Kitchen or whatever, with the chef that yells at everyone last night. I was watching that show. And this diner that had been in business like 30 years, guys. Okay, this guy, if you're in business 30 years, you've been doing something right. Well, the last 10 years, every single year, he's lost $30,000 to $50,000 in sales consistently over the last 10 years, to the point now where he's darn near out of business, okay? So the chef goes in and he's looking around and he's like, when was the last time you updated anything in this restaurant? And the guy said, we haven't updated anything since the day we opened. And he's like, I can smell the mold. Sorry to get off track here, guys. But he could smell moldy carpet, where they had carpet scrubbed the carpet so many times and didn't get it all out that it had actually had a mold stench to it. The plates, guys, the plates were the same plates they were using 30 years ago. The same bus trays. I mean, the same booths, same tables. They never upgraded anything. So, and this is a guy that's been in business 30 years, super successful the first 20 years, but, you know, became stagnant and became somewhat, I don't know what you want to call it, lazy, or just maybe thinking, hey, it's the food or the times are changing. In reality, what it was is he just was never updating his business to stay with the times. You know, people were looking for something a little more upbeat in the area. They went and looked at the competition. Like, they had TVs up on the wall and you could watch sports and news and just whatever. But this guy never changed at all. Not saying that you always have to change, but you have to make adjustments. And especially if you're losing money. So my channel is not just for the new guys. This channel is also for guys that have been doing this a long time that, you know, possibly are like, you know, the business isn't coming in like it used to be. What am I doing wrong? You know, I always try to be inspirational, guys. And I look to a lot of you guys for inspiration too. I watch a lot of channels, you know, I have quite a few. I'm not going to throw any names out, but these guys know I comment on their videos. I like their videos occasionally. And, you know, I look to those guys for inspiration too, you know, so, and a lot of YouTubers I look to. I don't know it all. I've never claimed to know it all, but I do know enough that, you know, I've been in business now, six going into my seventh season here, that I'm successful. I believe, you know, I'm going to continue success here. And the things that I'm doing that are, you know, helping me be successful are the things that I think a lot of people coming into the business or wanting to get into lawn care should be doing themselves, you know. Keeping a lot of the debt down, buying quality equipment, getting out and hitting the commercials early, guys. I cannot stress that enough, man. Guys always want to wait till spring and they think they're going to go get these commercials. And it's, you may land one and get lucky, but man, you got to be out there hustling. You got to be grinding, guys. I'm no joke. And that's not in, like, you know, trying to be any type of big-headed or anything. You just have to go out there. You have to put the time in. You have to talk to people. So I'm trying to stay busy here, guys. I know it seems like I've been in this garage a lot here lately, but this is my way of decompressing, or at least working off the stress, because I can't work. I can't work out. So I can at least come out here and do little things to make my garage and my business better. And that makes me feel gratification that, hey, I'm not just sitting around being lazy and, you know, waiting for the work to come back and my body to completely heal. I have to be doing stuff, guys. I have to be. It's in my blood. If you knew my father, you would understand. If you knew my brother, you would understand. We are not the type of people to sit around and just wait. We're not like that. It's not in our blood. We get crap done. It's just how we are. It's just, I don't know if it's the Indian blood we have in us. My great-grandmother, guys, not great-grandmother, great-great-great-grandmother. My grandfather's mother was Cherokee Indian. I mean, 100% Cherokee Indian. And I'll tell you like this, her name, you guys are probably going to laugh, but her name was actually America. That's how Indian she was. So, quick little funny story, guys, but I don't know. I can't sit around. I got to stay busy. So I went ahead and moved some stuff over here to this corner till I get a chance to put it away up top. But got the wife's car in here finally. She'll be happy with that. Not much room. As you guys can see, we got about 6 inches there between the skag and the back bumper. And then this side here, we're actually pretty decent on. But yeah, she'll be happy with that. Until she finds me something else to do. Later, fellas. As always, keep mowing, keep growing, keep making money, boys. I'll talk to you later.